Other young children may have dreamed of catching the long bomb to win the Super Bowl, or hitting the home run that clinches the World Series, but I played tennis 9 hours a day and made an annual ritual of building an elaborate replica of Wimbledon's center court out of an enormous collection of Legos. So when I received an email invitation from Babolat to join their unveiling of their new tennis racket and hit a ball with Garbiñ Muguruza, the current Wimbledon champion, I said yes. Only a week or so later, on a cab ride to the Manhattan Plaza Racquet Club in Midtown, did it suddenly dawn on me that I hadn't even picked up a racket in a year, was still suffering from a small tear in the elbow tendon of my hitting arm, the reason for not playing for a year, and knew virtually nothing about what I was walking into. What more reason, then, to square off opposite Muguruza, who, besides Wimbledon, also won last year's French Open, and is now the third-seeded woman at the US Open. First, the easy part, I was handed a brand spanking new Babolat Pure Drive racket. As I've been hitting with Babolat for years, much about the feel was familiar, though of course, in my reach for the stars fanboyism, I play with Rafael Nadal's Babolat, the Pure Aero Play, which is like a Sunday driver thinking that if he splurges on a Lotus instead of a Volvo, he'll be living his Formula One dream a bit sooner. The Pure Drive, to horribly bastardize Howlin' Wolf, seemed built for comfort and for speed, and in some early rallying with very good players who nonetheless hadn't recently won Wimbledon, my initial concerns about being left off the court were proven to be unfounded. Mostly. Muguruza herself couldn't have been more patient, more gracious, and more of a good sport, even as she was saying things about her racket like, "For me, it's all about the power. I like to feel like it's a weapon, and I can hurt with it." As for her thoughts going into the Open, she was remarkably even-keeled, considering the expectations heaped upon her after Wimbledon. "I never really do well here, I don't know why, the matches just haven't gone my way," she says matter-of-factly. "New York is a very tricky city, I find it very noisy. It's a jungle, and it's very stressful at times. But I'm ready for it." And with that, we head to the court, Garbiñ on one side with a partner, and me and a partner on the other, part of a handful of rotating doubles players. Essentially, we're fed three balls. If we win 2 out of 3 points, we win the mini game and are promoted to the other side of the net, lose the best of three and return to the back of the rotation to await your chance at redemption. Turns out that, surprise surprise, when you put a bunch of overeager amateurs on the same court with a Wimbledon champ, they, okay, we, try hitting out of our league. Far too many of our shots are being directed at Muguruza than should be the case, all of us harboring the same dream of blowing her mind with our power and pinpoint accuracy. Muguruza simply smiles and parries them back with ease. I net a couple of shots and am surprised to find myself emitting a truncated version of the same involuntary scream I trot out when playing with my regular hitting partner. Finally, a minor triumph, as I suddenly find myself near the net, Muguruza's partner, I'll assume this wasn't intentional, drills a forehand directly at my midsection, and in a form of self-preservation that seemed to last all of a microsecond, I throw my body to one side, drop my racket head slightly, loosen my grip a bit just at the moment of impact, and deliver a touch-drop volley that neither Muguruza nor her partner can even think of getting a racket on. Then I shank my next two shots, thus proving that the world is as it should be. That drop volley, though? Come next July, I'll no doubt be trying to reconstruct it with Legos.